Google has launched Gemini 2.0 Flash native image generation, with which we are able to generate amazing images. And not only image generation, this also allows us to edit images with the help of AI. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use this particular feature with their API in your own code. So let's get started. For this, just Google Google AI Studio. You'll be getting the first link from aistudio.google.com. Click it and make sure that you are signing in with your account. And if you want to try, and if you want to play around with this model, here to the right you'll be having the model, and change this to Gemini 2.0 Flash image generation experimental, and select the output format to images on text. You can just play around with it, like asking it to generate images. Now, in order to use this, to the left we are having this API documentation. Just open it, and in the documentation we'll be having how to set up Gemini API. In this, under capabilities, you'll be having the image generation. Under multimodal live API, you're having image generation. Just select it, and here they will be showing us how we can generate images. So there are two ways how we can generate images. One is by using this Gemini 2.0 Flash experimental model, and another one is by using ImageGen, which is also their image generation model. But they have mentioned here is that ImageGen is only available on the paid tier. And now if you just scroll up, here we are having the code for Gemini 2.0 Flash experimental, and below that we are having this flying pig image, and we are having this check out the image out guide. So you can just open it in a new tab. Basically, this will take us to a notebook that is imageout.ipynb. Here they will have all the code how we can generate images as well as edit the images. And here what you are doing is, at the top you are having this option called as run in Google Colab. Click here, and this will open us a Google Colab where we already have all the code written for us. So now let's just see how we can run this. First, it begins with installing the Google GenAI package. So just run this. Just don't mind this error, okay? And let's just move on to the next step. Next step is setting up your Gemini AI API key. So for that, here you need to again go to the Google AI Studio. To the top, you are having get API key. Click that. And here we are having create API key. Select it. And make sure that you are selecting any of your projects. In case if you don't have any projects, I guess it will show you option to create a project and select a key. And just click create API key in this project and copy the API key. And if you want to delete it, you can just delete this also. That's up to you. And now again, come to Colab. Actually, they have given like a code where we can like put the API key in some dot environment variable or user data to get it. We don't have to do that. I'm just going to directly hard code it. So here in the next step, initialize SDK client. Rather than this, I will remove it. And within double quotes, I'm going to just put the API key like this. And if I run this, yeah, green mark. And next, setting a model. So we are going to use Gemini 2.0 Flash experimental. That is done. We can just run this also. And yeah, we can run this code. This is basically the code which displays the image and saves the image. It has two parts. Because this is a multimodal, it can give output in the form of image as well as text also. So that's why we are having a condition here. This is for text. If a part is text, we are displaying the text. If it is not of type text, we are then calling the display image function. Okay, so that's how it works. We can just simply run this. Yeah, and here is the main part. This is the code where we are calling the display response, this particular function, and save image, this particular function over here also. Now what we can do is, here you are going to give the prompt. So I will just change this to image of a car. Just going so simple. And this is going to be the output response types, text as well as image. And I can just save the image as a car.png. And if I now run it, so as you can see here, I've got a car image. I don't know why it's giving me a back view of the car, but this image would be saved. For example, if I go to my files, and as you can see here, I'm having the car.png. So that exact same image generated will be saved over here. In case if you want to download it, you can just download it. That's totally up to you. Next, if you scroll down, here we are having a option to edit the images. And in case if you want to add your own image over here, you need to like upload an image. You need to upload the image to this particular default file directory, then only you can directly access it. So here, what we are doing is we are basically passing the image, and then we are also giving a single prompt how we can edit this. So I'm already having this car.png, right? So I'll just change the name of the like the image, and I'm just going to, hey, can you edit this image to red color? Okay, I'm just going to change the color to red. Okay, red color, and let me name the output response as red car, something like this. And now I will run this. So as you can see here, I've got a red color car. It was blue earlier and it's red, and just changed the color of the road also to red. That's good. Even the tree is red. And next, if you scroll down here, we are having get multiple images. So this method is so useful in case if you want to create recipes, which is the example that they have given. Basically, it will give you both text as well as images in the output. As you can see here, this is the text, some recipe, and we are having an image, then text, then images. So it's a mix of both. So I am going with this prompt, show me human evolution with images and description, and run this. So as you can see here, we have got a description and images, and this just goes on till the end. So this is basically how you can use this also, and they have given this with an example of a recipe. And next we are having the normal chat. Like here they have given the prompt as, yeah, can you draw a realistic, yeah, just quite similar to the image generation that we saw earlier. So you can just try it out in this particular Google Colab. You don't even have to write a single line of code. It's automatically given for you. And now let's see how we can use this exact same code in Visual Studio Code. In case if you want to create a REST API, let's see how we can like give the input as a request and get the image as a response in VS Code or run locally. Let's see that now. So I have just opened a empty folder in my Visual Studio Code. And for this, you must have Python already installed on your system. So if you don't have, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. So I will just go and create a new file. So let me name it as new.py. And basically, we're just going to add all the code from here. For example, we need to begin with this one. And you can just copy this and put it over here. So this is the first step. And next, model ID, we can directly give the model. And copy these also, the imports. And after the imports, here we're having the save image and display image. This is also important. So we can copy this code and put it after the API key, and also copy the imports. Okay, put it over here. And this is fine. We have done with this. Next is going to be the save functionality. So we can just copy these and put it at the last. Yeah, this is good now. And in the place of model ID, we can just put the model name like this, or else you can just copy that and put it also. I will just directly pass the model name over here. And after this, most important thing, we need to install the pip command. So and just copy, paste it here, and you can just remove this U and Q and as well as the exclamation mark. Just pip install the package name. Yeah, that's it. We are good now. And for running this, it's going to be Python space your file name with the extension. Hit enter. So we must get car.png in our folder if this works fine. Yeah, we got the image, but if I open this, it's saying an error occurred when loading the image. So to solve this, basically we just need to decode the image. So for that, you need to just add this code. Okay, so just import this base64, and here you need to add the decoded image. So it's going to be at the end, line number 27. Or if you just copy this, it's basically in the save image, inside the save image function. you need to put it over here, and rather than saving the data, you need to save the decoded data. That's it. And again, rerun. And now we have got, and if I go to car.png, as you can see here, I've got the image. So by this way, you can generate the images. And now let's see, what if you wanted this to be in a API? For example, I'll be sending the image prompt from Postman as a request, and in the output, we'll be getting the image generated as a response. So for that, it's so simple. Basically, you can literally copy the whole code, and you can just go to ChatGPT and ask, can you give me a Flask endpoint with image prompt as input and image as output response? Okay, so Flask is basically used to create API in Python. It's like a quick way to do that. So this will itself generate the entire code for us. Yeah, so as you can see, this is the code basically generated within a Flash, and we can just copy this code and just paste it. So basically what happens here is that the same thing, we aren't going to save it in local, so we aren't using that OS thing or something, import OS and stuff. We're having the Flask object app, and here we need to pass our API key, and we're having the same generate image over here, and at the end here we are just sending the image. Instead of saving the image, we are having the send file, which is also from Flask, and generating the image, and this is the image path, we are then just returning it. Okay, so let's see how this works now. So first thing, we have to replace our API key. So you can go to here, and here we are having the API key. So copy this and paste it. Yeah, that's good. And make sure that you are installing Flask. So to install Flask, it's pip install Flask. Okay, make sure that you are installing Flask. That's it. And just run the command python filename.py, and it has started on localhost 5000. And if you go again here, we'll be having the route also. So you can just copy this, go to Postman, paste the path, and it's going to be a post operation, post, and go to body. Here you'll be having raw, change this to JSON, and here it's going to be your input prompt. Just go with image of earth, something like this, and let's see what we are getting in the output, and send it. Okay, it says the requested URL was not found, and the reason is because here we are having generate underscore image, and here we are having hyphen image. So we can just change that. I don't know why it gave it this way. Yeah, so if I send it now, so we have got another error over here. It says model does not support image. So I guess since we are passing only here image, it's throwing us the error. So I'll just go here and add text also. So that's basically how it was earlier. So if you go over here, here we're having image also, text and image. So I don't know why it only passed text, the ChatGPT's code, but yeah, let's see. So it has restarted. And now if I send it again, so as you can see, finally I've got the image successfully in the response. So you can just have a front end like an app or a web page and display the image over there. So similar way, you can also create an endpoint for edit. You can just send the image in Postman as a form data, image and the prompt, and you can also get the output. So you can just try it out for editing the image. And that's the video, guys. I hope you'd have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of videos in programming and AI tools, Gemini AI, OpenAI, API also. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.